Hello, today I'm just going to show you how to do photo editing in your phone with a little software called Snapseed, made by Google. This software is just pretty powerful, a lot of features. Today I'm going to show you burning and dodge, which is a very simple technique and used to be the button. First of all, open Snapseed and open the image you want to edit. Now you can see I took this picture in England, France, and both sides pretty contrasty, and I want to fix that. First of all, they have a whole bunch of automatic filter. We'll give you a different kind of result, which is too easy for me. So I want to do the hard way. Pick on a tool, tap on the brush. There are four different kinds of brush. Today I'm going to show you how to use the burning and dodge tool. Okay. The burning dodge tool from minus 10 to plus 10 scale. The minus make it darker, plus to make things lighter. Let me see. Let's try the minus 5. You could build up, use two fingers and zoom in. And you could start painting the area you want. You can use different kind of setting. You can change in between. Sometimes tricky in the corner because that. Now I change to the lighter dodge tool to make the shadow area lighter. And since the brush size is always the same, so basically when you pan, it shows you the brush size. So when you zoom in more, your brush size is actually smaller. We have a smaller area. When you zoom out, the brush size is still the same, but we're covering the bigger area. Now, let me move to the other side. This is lighter side. I mean, this is darker side. I want to make it lighter. One of the ways to do it slowly is use the lower setting. But every time you paint on it, it will build up. But sometimes just too fast. Right. Okay. I purposely make a mistake. In the sky, you can see, I don't mean to dodge over there, but I just go back to the zero, to erase, and to fix that, no harm done. Continue to do the dark side and lighten up places that I want. Okay, not bad. So the density is right now. Let's change to another tool, the color temperature brush. I want to, the shadow area is a little bit too bluish. So I try to warm up the color temperature in that area a bit with a low setting. You can see, pretty effective. I mean, it's not every area you need to do it, but you zoom in, then you could do it more accurate. You zoom out, and let's look at the overall. Not too bad. When you're done with the tool, you just check it. Now I want to go into another tool, the perspective. Just make a little bit correction with the free distortion tool and just pick the building straight up a little bit. Now it's about it. And then go to the tool, make an image. You have to do an overall adjustment on different things. Brightness, saturation, ambient, highlight, darken the highlight a little bit, open the shadow a little bit more, and do a warming. And since this picture doesn't need a lot of warming, I'll leave it. If you like it, click export. Now usually I will export as make another copy just to be safe. And as you can see, they have different feature and different way to export, and you could use whatever way you like. Just use export. Let's take a look. Oh, this is the final result. Let's go to the gallery. You can see this before and after. This is before, this is after. It's not bad, right? It's took me about 5 minutes, and with the software, right, do it right on your cell phone and doesn't have to go to computer, Photoshop, things like that. Thank you for watching. If you like it, click like or subscribe. I hope we all have fun today. Thank you.